Daniel Horton of the Bendigo Braves, thanks for joining us.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Daniel, tell us a bit about yourself, about where you've played ball previously and how you ended up being in Australia.
Well, I played college ball at the University of Michigan, Go Blue. Then I was with the Miami Heat for preseason. I left there and went to Turkey. And I played in France for a couple years and played in Cyprus for like 2 weeks. And then played in the D-League for about a year total, so I've been a little bit everywhere.
So you've been around a bit, I mean, but you've played a few preseason games here in Bendigo. What's the biggest difference to the SEABL League to some of the other leagues you've played in?
The game isn't as fast as it is in Europe or with Miami, but it's still a pretty good competition level, and you know, guys make you work. You know, it actually might be just as physical, a little bit more physical than couple leagues that I've played in, so it's been pretty good so far.
And yourself, Daniel, what do you see your strengths as a player?
Just a playmaker. You know, I can score, I can get find guys that when they're open, I can pride myself on my defense. So I feel like I'm a multifaceted player that can bring different things to this team to help us win.
And mate, how are you adjusting to life in Australia? What's been the biggest challenge for you so far?
To be honest, it really hasn't been any challenge, just being so far away from my family back in the States, but I'm used to that by now. This is my fifth or sixth year playing ball overseas, so Bendigo's been one of the better places I've been so far, so I've really enjoyed it.
Now mate, I heard you had a bit of trouble though adjusting to driving on the wrong side of the road, a bit of a mishap there?
Yeah, following Trent Bicey driving 100 kilometers an hour on the side street, and I had a little snake in the road, and I didn't snake and hit the curb, so had to get used to the most of the car being on the left side instead of the right side. So,
mate, your teammates, how are you adjusting to fitting in, and Coach Harvey?
They've been great. I mean, they just really encouraged me to be myself and play the way I always play. And the good thing is the way I play fits in really well with the guys on the team. And it's a very player-friendly system, and coach is a player's coach, so it's been pretty good so far.
Mate, Bendigo have made it to the conference championship the last 2 years, but they've just missed out on the national championship. Has that been talked about with you as a player?
Yeah, definitely. That's the one thing Coach Harvey and I discussed a lot before I got here, just talk about the process of getting better every day first, and then eventually lead us to winning a championship. And that's really the Braves' only goal now. They've, like you said, they've been to the conference final, they lost in the grand final last year, so now it's just all about winning a championship. Anything less would be considered a failure for us.
Well, mate, we're certainly looking forward to seeing you hit the court and hopefully lighting it up for the Braves this year. So good luck this year, and thanks for your time today.
Thank you very much.